It's the group's final day at East Shallowford Farm. There's just time to say some goodbyes and for Pam the chef to divulge the recipe for her delicious flapjacks.
Roll the syrup together until it's sort of fine. Then you add the rolled oats.
The past few days have been quite an experience for our young visitors. Very different to life in Battersea.
I hate this estate. I hate the people on the estate. I hate the police constantly on the estate. I hate the little weed smokers on the estate. But then, hey, my nieces and nephews live here, so.
Laura's 22 now. She considers her trips to Dartmoor an invaluable part of growing up. The farm offered her time away from her 9 siblings and Battersea in general.
A lot of work does go into it, a lot of thought and a lot of planning. And they do it all for us. They don't ask for nothing from us in return. And to think that some of the kids that go down there, they're work. They are work. They're a lot of work. And they still have kids year after year coming back. You know, there's been kids that I would never have in my home, yet year after year, Miss Braun allows everyone to come back. It's great.
It should never stop. Yeah. But if it did, it'd be weird.
They get very thirsty in this weather.
5 decades have passed since Miss Braun founded the Youth Christian Centre in Battersea. Hundreds of kids and several generations have visited the farm in Devon.
We've got a lot to be very, very grateful for in the way it has gone on, and the people who support it, and the families and the people who've grown up themselves and come back to us have been a great help to us and come along, and we've enjoyed all that. In between all the upsets we have too.
Bye. Departure time is drawing near, and whilst the lads will be leaving country life behind, they'll be taking a wealth of memories back to London with them. Elizabeth Braund and Rosemary can say cheerio to this minibus full of teenagers, safe in the knowledge that another one will be along very soon.
Bye, Coco! Bye! Bye, Coco!